Okay, welcome back. In this class, we're going to look at how to add header and footer in WPS Office Suite. So to add a header and footer, we just created this document. If you have remembered from the beginning, just a normal text that we have. So if you want to add a header and footer, all you need to do is to come from the Home tab over here to the Insert tab. You can come to Insert, and you have the option to insert header and footer over here. You can see header and footer. Once you select header and footer, the header and footer option is going to come in directly from here, and you can see it directly from here. This is header and footer. So header and footer as a tab here, you can see all the different features that you have access to as you are writing the header and footer. So you can insert page numbers if you want. There are different kind of formats to insert page numbers. You can do entire document, you can do from current page, or you can do from a section. You can apply this the position of the numbering, okay, from left, center, right, outer, inner. You can do all that, and you can have different kind of formats in the page numbering. You can see different kind of numbers from 1 to 2, 1 with dashes, 1, 2, 3 with dashes, and you have page 1, page 2, page 1 of 2, page 1, 3 of 5, page 3 of 10, or thereabout. You can do all that, and you can see different kind of formatting and arrangement. Once you select OK to this, it's going to take in as the format of the page number. Now, page number also you can insert from here. Once you have the header and footer enabled, you can come over here. You can see different kind of styles like we've just explained earlier. You can delete a page number if you want, or you can insert it directly. Assuming I want to insert at the top head left, okay, or you can do bottom, just like the way we have in our normal document, footer middle. So you can just select on this, and you can see page 1 and page 2 arranged over here, okay. So if you want to have show header line, you can even include the header line for this. You can show header line. Once you select, it's going to have the lines at the header. You can see it's going to have the lines at the header. All the headers are going to have this line defined. And at this moment, I don't want to show it. So you can say delete line, and it's gone. You can have add text. You can do page X if you want, page Y of page, total of page, of total of Y page, page X of Y. So you say page X means page 1, page 2, just like so. And if you want to do page X of Y, which means page 1 of 2, because there are two pages here, and this is the first one, this is page 2 of 2. So you can delete the other one, okay. You have to delete first. You have to come over here and delete page numbering. After you've deleted, then you can come over here and say page X of Y. So this is page 1 of 2, and then you can come page 2 of 2 of 2, or thereabout. You can see the arrangement that we've selected at the top right, top left of the page. That's when you see it. And if you want, you can add date and time. You can click to add date and time, and you'll be able to select between the different available formats. Is it this normal date time, or with the date just like so, Sunday, June 11, 2023, or 2023, this format. But let's say we are going with this format, United States, the language, and you can update automatically as the document is being opened in another date. Maybe, for example, at a subsequent date, not today. Can click on OK, and it's going to insert that date for you if that's what you want. Or you can equally select it and move it somewhere. Okay, you can move it somewhere with the tab key. If you want, you can keep it at the extreme end, or define wherever you want to put it within the document, and it's going to be there throughout the header and throughout the header. Okay, so you can have date and time, or if you want have any picture that you want to insert, you can insert from a file, from picture to text, or from a PDF, picture to PDF, or you can insert from other devices as well. You can bring in text, or you can bring in your image from a file, and you can just easily attach it directly. So for example, I want to insert this, put this as one of the images in my header. All you need is just to bring it in, and then you can scale it down to smaller size. So you can just fit in, and maybe you want to add your logo or thereabout, or your company logo or thereabout. You can make it smaller, and you can see you can crop it also. The different features that you have, you can crop it, or you can convert the picture to text or picture to PDF. You can do all that from here. So this is still on header and footer. So you can still come back to the header and footer, and you can see we're still on the header and footer. Once you double click, okay, so you have the option to switch between header and footer. You can switch between, you can change the fields, or you can come to previous header. If you wanted to have previous header or next header, you can also insert accordingly. You can do header and footer options. You can change, you can check, and you can increase or decrease the height from here if you want, or you can insert alignment tab if you are interested in that. You can come over here to do page setup. You can arrange the pages accordingly. So it's very easy to insert header and footer. All you need is just to understand that this feature works perfectly as you want it. You can delete a page number. You can insert, you can change the format like we've explained, and you can rebuild the page number directly from here. Okay, continue numbering or thereabout. And once you're done, you can come over here and close. And if you want to delete any page number, like I have shown, you can come over here and just delete the page numbering directly. Okay, so it's very easy. Once you're done editing the page header and footer, you can either double click out, or you can come over here and close, and you have whatever you have as your header and footer, just like we've explained. Okay, so I think that does it for this class on how to insert header and footer. So thanks for watching. In the next class, we're going to look at how to write some basic equations in WPS document. Until that time, thanks for watching, and I look forward to seeing you in the next class. Bye.